four important operators and the eigenstates. Okay. They are extensively used in quantum optics. So we have already seen there is an X operator, there is a P operator. Okay. This X is often replaced with Q. So I write Q for X. And then P, and then I take another operator A, which is annihilation operator, and then I take a number operator N, which is a dagger. Alright. Now, for this Q operator, I denote this eigenvalue equation, where this is the operator, this is eigenstate, this is the eigenvalue, and this is the eigenstate again. Here the Q can take real values ranging from minus infinity to infinity. Alright. For P, likewise, I have this P operator, then let's say P's are the eigenstates, cat P's are the eigenstates, then the eigenvalue. Here, P can take any value ranging between minus infinity and plus infinity. These two cases are quite different from the above in the following sense. A's eigenstate is a very special eigenstate. Okay. And this special eigenstate is called as coherent state. This is indeed the quantum state that you see in your laser light, without which it's very difficult to imagine our society today. You see your medical and everywhere, you can't survive without lasers, and the quantum states that govern the laser physics is your coherent state. This value here, alpha, takes, alpha belongs to the set of complex numbers. Okay, these are real, continuous, this is complex. Lastly, this number operator, its eigenstates are again special. Its eigenstate, okay, I write this capital N as N cap. I'm putting the hat because there are also no hat versions of them which represent the eigenvalue. So, the eigenstate of this number operator is nothing but your number states or the Fock states. This. And the range of values that n can take is quite different from all of them, as n can take discrete range of values only. Okay. Of course, I'm not giving the details of them. This is completely harmonic oscillator business, this is coherent state business that we would be discussing completely differently in a different series of lectures. And of course, this is something, this is a very standard result from, you know, harmonic oscillator, quantum harmonic oscillator. Now, yeah, these are the Fock states. Let me make a couple of quick remarks about this coherent state and Fock states. Firstly, Fock states define a very nice basis for many operators. Okay. That is one, and of course they form a complete basis. And for most of the quadrature operators, you know, we know that the operators are represented in bases, like right? Different bases. So most of the times, many quadrature operators are represented in the Fock state basis. Well, what is special about this coherent state? One particular speciality about this coherent state is they are the minimum uncertainty states. Okay. These are the minimum uncertainty states. And another thing is they are the closest quantum states to the states of classical harmonic oscillator. Okay, we know we have this classical harmonic oscillator. the quantum equivalent for the states of classical harmonic oscillator are nothing but your coherent states, because they show the minimum uncertainty. Okay. Quantum equivalent of states. So this is something that we must be familiar with in order to proceed with the higher level calculations and higher level theory. Okay, so yeah, these are the four important operators, and these are the eigenstates and their ranges, and to which set of numbers they belong basically. Alright, these two are specialist state, coherent state and Fock state, and of course this coherent state is again written as a infinite superposition over this n state in the following way. A coherent state is defined as e power minus alpha square by 2, a summation over an infinite sum where the coefficients are this, and it's a summation over the number states or the Fock states. Okay. Alright, let's go to some probability distributions now. And of course these things are important and we will be using them in later part of it.